Last year, a lot of people said a lot of things about Echofox. Many things that had to be addressed or whatnot. We just tried to get through it, and we did, and we all learned a lot. Coming into this new season, we're trying to do everything new, trying to work Echofox from the inside out, just hit a real hard reset button. This isn't about 2019 or just one single season or year. It's about building a team that has a longevity and a system in place where it's a high level of professionalism and instill success in all the staff and players. And going into the future, it's not an overnight process, and we understand that. And I think that's why we are so successful and we are going to be successful.
So our offseason started with Smoothie asking to be traded. He had an opportunity to go to TSM and he was really interested in that. And so Rick and Khalid coming in, knowing that this season was going to be a lot of them rebuilding the organization, they gave Smoothie an opportunity to go there. So the entire roster building started with the idea that we weren't going to have Smoothie anymore. In 2018, Rick didn't have that much say over how the roster got built since there were a lot more people kind of like in the kitchen. And so now in 2019, it was him and Khalid who were really like the heads of that. And they were really inside of all the meetings with us, with the coaches, and trying to figure out exactly where they wanted to push this roster and have some sort of say so that way they were more of a part of it.
The coaching staff and I looked into keeping Darak or how we can have him on the team. We did look for other junglers at the time, and we were successful in getting Rush, and that meant that Darak was going to be on the academy roster. Our upper management reached out to him, told him about the situation, and we wanted to let him know that it's possible to look for other opportunities.
What?
My only worry about sending Darak to Optic is the 10th place team, right? So you're making Optic better.
Yeah, I agree.
And every conversation I had with Jared last year was always, if you're trading a player, you try and trade them to a team that you're either, they're already going to be good, so you give it to a team that's already going
to
be good.
That's why I wanted to send them to TSM.
Okay, yeah, that's where my mind is. Okay, I'm going to run the same page.
Well, Darak's in a good mood. Optic, they give him an offer, and they both agreed on the terms. So if Darak doesn't find a better offer by Sunday, Darak told me personally, I've been on Skype too, if he doesn't find a better offer by Sunday, he is going to,
he's going to sign with Optic.
At least now we will not have bad PR ever regarding Darak. So right now, if we want to do the post about Rush now, I think right now might be a good time for you to call Darak and tell him, hey, I heard your conversation with Optic went well, that sounds good, and then tell him about the Rush situation.
Hello?
Hey, Darak.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, it's Rick. So I was getting caught up with Justin here, and he was telling me how your day went with, I think it's Optic, and that you were reaching an understanding with them. Is that correct?
Yeah, we're getting pretty deep in our conversations, yeah.
Oh, okay. But no, I just want to make sure you were getting not only options, but you were having conversations and you were feeling like you had some options and you were going to be able to find a place.
Yeah, definitely weighing my options. I'm getting a lot of good offers that I'm happy about.
So. Good. Oh, that makes me happy to hear, man.
Yeah, I told Optic that I would be... that I'm going to shop around for the next couple of days, but if I don't get anything that is, more appealing, or I don't have anything to counter them with, I'm going to close on the deal. I'm going to feel comfortable closing on the deal on Sunday with them.
I don't know if you heard the rush conversation out there in the ethers, but we, I think in the last day here or two, since we started getting you into other conversations, went and secured a jungler for the team. So if you hear that communication out there, I wanted to let you know myself that that's what has transpired here, okay?
Okay, sounds good. Thanks for letting me know.
I'm glad he has a team, though. Like,
no, he has a home now, man, at least. Yeah. At least. Like, he knows that I've been actively looking for him. He's, like, always saying thank you, and, like, he's good.
But, yeah, it's not a good feeling to be out in the cold, man.
Yeah. You put him in the deep end.
Well, no, we tried.
I mean, in a good way, people like Joshua, he has to run before he walks. That's the kind of person that he has.
Look, we tried to build around him, and
then you realize now.
I don't think he understood, man. I don't think he understood the state of his career when it comes to the risks people are willing to take with him.
Yeah.
Even though we got through a full season with him, it wasn't because it was all bed of roses. I mean, it was a volatile season.
On top of that, we also knew that Hooney and DeMonte's contracts were up after the end of this year, and that ended up leaving us in a pretty good spot where we could just pick up Clutch's trio which Clutch was willing to trade to us. And from there, we were able to just fill out our roster with two other people instead of having to try and find all these individual pieces.
Our room with the activation.
Hey, yeah. Did you guys see the Rush Phoenix reaction?
No. We made the announcement. Echo Fox, excited to welcome.
Yeah. Rush, and welcome back, Mid Phoenix.
There you go, man.
Can't wait to see the reaction.
It's good stuff. Welcome back, Phoenix.
It's a good picture, too.
So, Rush to stream. Good. That's going to happen.
Here you go.
GG Rush, number one jungler in NA history. Rush, Echo Fox goes from most hated to most loved team overnight.
Rick was a real big champion of wanting to bring Phoenix back. So he initially brought up the idea of bringing Phoenix back. And we had already been talking to Rush and many other junglers trying to see where their interest laid. And when Rush heard that we were talking to Phoenix, something clicked with the two of them and they were both really excited and they both just started eagerly messaging us saying, hey, we both want to be on this team if we're with the other guy.
I feel like Phoenix has been a little bit underrated and he promised to me that he will not be toxic this year. He will be a team player, he will place a pink ward, he will not die side lane, his toxicity has been overrated and his player skill has been a little underrated. That's my opinion. So I heard that Phoenix is gonna sign, so I signed Echo Fox too.
When I first found out I was getting traded to Echo Fox, it was pretty late in the offseason, preseason. But I heard they were getting Coach Song, so I thought as long as the roster was good, he would be able to make it work. And I know that playing with Paul and Colin, I know what they like and like how they play, so it wasn't like that hard to adapt.
I mean, this roster is good. We definitely have potential. I think it really has to do with our coaching staff too. I've been actually wanting to be coached by Coach Song for a while. I knew that Envy wanted to pick up Song, and then eventually Immortals got Song at that point. And then Song did really well in Immortals, and they, you know, pretty much went from like a middle tier, like lower tier team to like one of the best teams.
At the base, you guys have to communicate and coordinate about how to use our jungle pressure, or how to use our rain priority.
So I think not only the players, but like the coaching staff is like a really good match right now. So yeah, it's just really, really good. Everyone is, yeah, like a veteran basically. Everyone's been playing for a while. Everyone acts like a professional, which is really nice. It's not really common, I'd say. There's usually like one or two kind of like young, maybe more mature in some rosters, but this roster is like just really professional. We're all trying to get better. You know, we're not the best team in the LCS yet, so we're gonna keep working at it. And I think all of us really have that same mentality.
All right, good morning, guys. So this is our first week of practice before LCS, so now it's the real deal. We have LCS literally next weekend, so it's time to be extra focused. Let's fix our early game stuff, and that's a bit about what me and Song think right now that the team's really lacking is obviously our early game sucks. We keep losing at like 20 minutes or FFing at 15 minutes, and that has to stop, and it starts with our pregame planning.
So we're going up against two teams that a lot of our players are from, Golden Guardians and Clutch, so it's a really interesting week for a lot of the players. I'm sure all the Clutch guys really want to go up against Clutch and do well. They have a really similar style to what we ran last year with Echo Fox, so I think it's a matchup that we could do really well in.
So when we first started scrimming, it was kind of rough just because we didn't know each other's play styles, besides like Colin, Apollo, and I. So trying to adjust with the new jungler and new mid is a lot different since they usually control like how the early game goes. Initially, we were losing a lot of scrims, but I think over time we've been winning a lot more. I'm feeling pretty good about week one. I think we have a pretty good chance versus both the teams to play against. I think as long as we play our game, we'll be able to win.
Thank you for joining us back here for game 5, where we have ourselves a classic John Travolta and Nick Cage situation as Clutch Gaming and Echo Fox will face off.
I think the big one, at least for me, is Clutch, just because, yeah, I was on the team last split. It's definitely like a little more motivation, I'd say, going into it, because I think both sides really want to win. And of course, it's like obviously the first match as well, but it's just like there's kind of a lot of hype built around it. Both, a lot of players were on each other's teams. Just, yeah, it's gonna be exciting.
I'm pretty sure the Clutch Gaming guys, especially Funi and Piglet and Dante, really don't know how to play during the mid game. So just keep in mind, even we are behind early, it's not a problem. It's really not a problem. We can come back every time and then I'm pretty sure they're nothing special. Maybe I want to just edit about that.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen, on to Summoner's Rift for the last game of the day.
It was a tough game. I mean, they had a lot of early game priority, especially with the Rumble pick and having Camille Gallio. So we knew early game was going to be hard, and a lot of it was going to be us surviving and scaling.
I'm fine.
Rumble
Are you
flash?
Okay? Maybe not. He's no fight. Can you fight or not?
No fight.
Yeah,
give her con, maybe. Yeah.
First blood over to Hootie, who spots him out and equalizes him.
Yeah, the things I liked about how we handled today, just being able to communicate well with each other and come up with a plan to come back and to, you know, give us the best chance to win.
And now it's Echo Fox who has the opportunity to turn around and grab that ever so juicy Infernal Drake. And let's wait.
Got no
and Lyra.
And he has no ward.
And he has no flash. So if you go in at all, this could be a suicide.
Oh!
He gets it! That's 2017 envy, Lyra. That's which Lyra we saw today.
The only thing I thought was funny that that when Lyra stole dragon, the first thing I thought about was, man, this guy missed every smite last season, and then now he steals our dragon. And I think Apollo thought the same thing, which was pretty funny.
As the Infernal Drake will spawn in 30
base
seconds.
Jacks.
Lyra, that is not where you want to be, my friend, and there is no way you're saving him out of that one. Vulcan looking to return some damage now onto their opponents. Equalizer down onto a choke point there in the middle of the jungle. Rush channels the ulti, not going to find any kills with it just yet. Hootie looking for some damage here down onto Scullion. Damante wants to go in, able to find the junk, but it's only down onto the Scion. Very tanky with the adaptive helm. Still going to be kept alive. Piglet into the back line. Multiple members low, but the kills will not come through. It's a double kill over to Rush. It's Echo Fox coming up huge.
They turn it around. Even Phoenix survives with a beautiful stopwatch there. What a fight for Echo Fox. They needed it.
There's big plays, and then there's that. What a turnaround to the side of Echo Fox.
We had a competition that if we were able to scale and lose slowly, we'd be able to reach a point in the game where we were able to take control and win fights, and Clutch just played really well around their windows and their timings, and Hooney had some great ultimates and some forced good engages.
Sivir relies on that summoner, relies on the protection of her team, and they are going in.
Oh, she's trying to get out, but Solo wants to go around. He tries to drift it, but it won't quite work just yet. Lyra going in on top of multiple people.
That equalizer!
Down, but the equalizer's got some damage. It's a rampage over to Damante. A double kill as he takes down Rush. Echo Fox is heading for the hills, but they're heading for the graveyard first. It's four dead, and Clutch Gaming will push for the win.
What a back and forth game this was. So, so close in so many of the team fights. People living with one auto, you know, 10% HP. Both teams staying in it for so long.
Hey, I have never won my first game in LCS.
Yeah?
I didn't tell you guys.
That's okay.
But also, oh, yeah. I didn't have never had 0-2 week for my entire life.
Oh,
no.
Yeah.
Really?
It's okay. We'll be
watching. Clutch was a rough loss, I would say.
Going into Parson's Clutch Gaming, you really wanted me, but it didn't happen. But yeah, it sucked, but it's really happy to Hooney and Damante performing really well.
I think it was a good learning point for us, and we were able to improve the things that we weren't able to quite work on in practice that we didn't, the problems that we hadn't found yet. I'm excited for what we've learned from it and what we can take from it, and actually you could see some of that progress on our game on Sunday.
How does it look like?
Wait a minute.
More?
Yeah.
Wait a minute.
You missed this spot.
Oh.
The
king
burst.
Okay,
because they're
going to
get it better.
We are back to close out week one of the LCS, or the Legendary League of Legends League, with Echo Fox versus Golden Guardians.
I was the head coach for Golden Guardians last year, and we got 2 10th place finishes in a row. Really, really rough year. Although I didn't get to finish out my second year, where I think we were in like 7th when they released the coaching staff. So yeah, I really wanted to beat Golden Guardians. Just like our Clutch players, they wanted to prove that they came to a better place and came to a better team, and I wanted that same thing for myself. So. Really excited to play against GGS, win or lose.
They're gonna go.
Hey, rise on flash.
I will ulti first.
I'm in.
Stay with the Kaiser, stay with the carry. Sorry.
And I don't know if it was the best idea, boys. They get taken down by Echo Fox.
Woo!
He's like, Haku, oh no, you did not.
Oh no, you did not.
Just try to go on my turret.
that game was really easy after ball lane got such a lead, and also Rush getting a pretty big lead just by, you know, out farming.
Yes, he can get in with the quickness.
There it is.
The dodge, there's one hit, he gets three. Froggen's gonna be able to knock up the three in the fight, actually, as Phoenix is on the outside, but they're still able to fire in. The AD carries are untouched here as they start to deliver damage, and they have their eyes set on those priority targets. Requiem from Death here coming from Rush, so they can get a bit more damage and keep Phoenix. And Paolo, save. Look at the smile on Rush's face. He's having a great time.
On Saturday, we were a little bit shaky in our engages and trusting our calls, and we talked about it Saturday night right after the game, right after we lost the clutch. We were like, hey, like, we need to fix these things, and we need to fix them for tomorrow if we want to win. And you could see it coming into Sunday. Like, everyone felt really confident. We listened to our engages. Haku played super well, so did Apollo, and it was just smooth sailing. On the other side, it didn't seem like smooth sailing because I was so nervous because I really wanted to win, but you could feel like it was going to be a win.
Damn, I trolled this game. Thanks for carrying it, Paul.
It's okay. I threw that as well.
Yeah, Nick and Paul really cared. I'm not gonna lie.
Should we punish him?
And then, an Echo Fox able to rise up in a fiery storm, take down Golden Guardians, and they'll be 1-1 in the first week of the LCS.
I think we performed around where I think everyone expected. We might have been, could have played a little bit better, but that's always kind of how it is on stage. You think you can always play a little bit better.
Rome wasn't built in a day, and so if we do want to be a playoff contender, we do want to be a top team, we do want to be able to beat TL in the finals or something like that, that's going to take a lot of time. We all understand what we want. We want to go to Worlds, we want to perform well in playoffs, we want to be a team that succeeds this year. And all of us have, in the past, not really been able to prove ourselves, or at least for a long time, like Phoenix and like Apollo, Rush, Solo, Hakuo. Like, all these players are good, they've been proven that they've been good, but they've never quite been able to reach their full potential. And so something that me and Song really wanted to do for these guys is give them the environment and the work ethic that they need to be the best and to become a great team. And that doesn't happen overnight.
My goal for 2019 is go to Worlds. That's what it's been for the past 2 years. I've always wanted to go to Worlds, so we just have to keep working hard and hope that we can get there with our effort. Everybody that comes in here probably wants to go to Worlds, and they know the pressure that it takes to get there. You have to deal with the fans, the media, like everybody watching you play. So you just have to adapt and get used to it.
All the players are really giving their best effort moving forward for this. They all want it really badly. I can see it from all the hard work they put in, all the triple blocks they're doing, all the extra solo queue they're playing. If we work triple block 3 to 4 times a week for scrims, and if we have all these VOD reviews and we answer all the hard questions and we face adversity together, that work in the long run is going to put us there.